if you're feeling low, then give it a go.
You know when you're doing a song about a small town?
Try Lambert Sniffing Salts today.
You get it started with appreciate, you know what I'm saying? Lie. Time moves a little slower here.
G'day folks, welcome to another one of our boat reviews here in our shop warehouse in Miranda in Sydney. We've made a couple now. Got to tell you, I've been a little bit surprised by the reaction. People have been fairly encouraging about them, which with the traffic noise outside and the rudimentary gear we've got to record them and our lack of experience, you know, sometimes you can fluke things. So I'm Mark Sundin. I'm from Expedition Kayaks. This is the Think 6. This is not an independent review. This is not a punter telling you what he thinks about a ski. I sell Think skis. I've been a dealer of theirs for nearly 10 years. We love selling their boats, and I hope that a nice, honest appraisal of what this boat is all about, where it comes from, and who's going to enjoy paddling it, will help you to consider it the next time you're looking to make a ski purchase. A little bit about me. If you haven't seen any of our other videos, I'm an ocean paddler, a sea kayaker, as well as a surf ski paddler. I love being out in waves. I'm not a flat water paddler, really. I go on a few races because they're fun, and a lot of people I know go in them, and why not? But really what I love doing is catching waves, being out in the ocean. I'm not gonna give you any statistics. I'm not gonna tell you how fast it goes, because I haven't even really checked. What I'm really all about is how the boat feels on the water and how successful it is at providing a step for people who've been paddling for a little while, and this is an intermediate ski, so you wouldn't expect a beginner to be able to jump in it. In fact, I'd be really surprised if any were able to. So I guess before you talk about one of their skis, you really need to have a little bit of a background about Think. They're a Canadian company. They've been in business for, you know, the best part of the last 12, 13 years, as far as I know. Here in Australia, they're represented by Stu O'Regan, our good mate, who's done a great job by himself, more or less, in promoting Think skis, getting them into the hands of some good paddlers, as well as starting people off on their surf ski lives in some of the boats that are easier to handle. They are designers. These boats aren't inspired by anything else. They don't talk about distractions like a super new lightweight way of making them, a super shiny new finish they've managed to get on their boats, a bow shape that's completely out of this world and weird, something to distract you and take your eyes away from what really matters, and that is how their boats go through the water. If you have a look at Think's literature, it's top heavy with performance-oriented stuff, what the boat does, how it works, you know, and I love that. I couldn't care less whether it's 9.8 kilos or 10.5 kilos. I couldn't care less if you can get a matte finish on it instead of a shiny finish or a clear carbon finish. I really couldn't even care less about some ridiculously revolutionary thing that is supposed to make it perform like no other boat's ever performed, because we've all seen that happen, right? Usually badly. So they are designers first. They have held their own in the surf ski market now for a long time against some of the powerhouses. And the reason for that is they're very honest. They sincerely believe they make great boats. You know, they some of their designs are so different in so many ways, towards the same end of coming up with an elite intermediate transition beginner ski. But they're not following anyone else's script, and I really admire them for that. The 6 itself was highly anticipated, coming as it did a couple of years after the release of the Zen, which is the yellow boat behind me on the wall. Now the Zen kind of stands on its own now as a boat in between a beginner's boat and this kind of boat. Very flat through the midsections, really nice and friendly to paddle, but again, not a beginner's boat. So people who are ambitious would have no trouble having a crack at the Think Zen as a first boat and having a fair bit of success with it. And that's the way it's proven to be since it was released. This one, there was word at the time when it was being developed, they might, you know, maybe it might be called the Zen Max or the Zen 2 or whatever. And I kind of thought they should do that because the Zen was such a popular boat. And in hindsight, they were right to give it its own name and its own identity, because this is definitely not a long Zen. This has many of the characteristics of Think Skis down through the years. It's not an attempt to dumb down an intermediate boat. And having paddled it now for the best part of the last couple of months in a whole big wide range of conditions, having had people get in it, try it, many of them order it, I think I've, you know, worked out where it fits and how it behaves. So if you're happy to sit there and have a cup of tea or a cold beer, I'll take a few minutes and run you through the Think 6. So first up to the seat and the seating position and the ergonomics of the cockpit. Think are almost universally well loved for the shape of their buckets, the way their foot plates interact with where you sit, how you sit, and the amount of contact you get with the bucket and the entire seating position. They are a lot more proscriptive than a lot of other skis. They force you to sit in a certain position, which is a very good position. This section here tends to be a little narrower than a lot of boats, so your legs are forced together into a position that you really should be in from the beginning. And a common reaction when people get into a Think ski for the first time is, gee, it fits well, doesn't it? You know, especially some of the smaller skis. This one is the biggest bucket they have. This is the widest bucket. It's, I believe, derived from the bucket that's in the Think Ace, which is their entry-level boat. Another one of those skis with wide appeal, designed for beginners. So if you've never fitted into a Think ski before, there's a fair chance you might fit into this one if you're at that upper end of the weight range or you've got wide hips. However, it's not for really wide-hipped people. And in fact, if you look at the surf ski market now, there ain't an awful lot around for people with really wide hips. They have struggles getting into quite a lot of boats nowadays. Whereas back when I first started paddling, they tended to cater for them a lot more. Flip side of that was people with narrow hips found that they were sliding around inside. So this one's an attempt to compromise on that, give it a nice broad range of paddlers, and you always feel like your bum is higher than your feet in a Think ski. It's a lovely feature of their ergonomics. Down at this end of the boat, of the cockpit, all Think skis come with a non-slip set of foot pads, so you don't pay any extra for that. It's another nice feature. Really important, especially if you're paddling in an environment where your feet can slip, so waves, anywhere where things are moving around. The two foot straps, I actually prefer the way that feels when I'm sitting in a boat, being able to get contact with the back of my foot. That, of course, is the back of my hand, but you get the picture. So that when I'm driving down with one heel, I'm pulling back and feeling pressure against the back. It makes the boat feel more stable, I think, having those points of contact. They have I don't know if the camera will pick this up, but they've got a bailer system now that they've been using for a couple of years. It's the easiest of the lot to kick down and back heel with your foot when you want to empty the bucket. Works like a treat. You know, all the bailers nowadays seem to have gotten pretty good. This one's no exception. And there's a tether point for your leg leash, right out of the way, smack in between your legs, doesn't get caught up on anything. And obviously that thing there, that's a hell of a lot more important than your life jacket, in my opinion. And it's nice to have a dedicated place for that to sit. The carry handles are shaped so they don't get in the way of your legs, really important. They're nice and long and you can get your hand underneath them. You wouldn't be able to get your hand underneath and put it in a dangerous position if you were hanging onto the boat by them, banging around in surf if you'd fallen off. So they're a great design. They're made from an alloy, no rust, no drama, nice and light as well, keeping the boat's weight down. And the adjustment system in the Think is a bit of a pain in the bum when you're like me, and this is our demo boat. So it's one of those ones that we're constantly changing the leg lengths and shifting things around. You've got to undo these screws to move the plate forward and aft. But once you've done it in your own boat, I'm pretty sure you're not going to do it very often after that. So the little tiny teeth that they have in their foot plate adjustment system means that you never get caught between two pegs. Sometimes you have a ski that you own and you think, gee, I just never seem to be able to get the seat right or the leg length right. Well, that's never going to happen with a Think ski because the increments of advance in the foot plate adjustment are so tiny, you'll always be able to get it into a position that suits. Moving right along to the hull, you'll notice, if the camera will pick it up, this is another one of those lovely hulls devoid of any sharp angle changes. Nothing about it suggests that there'd be some particular point on the hull that would trip you up, catch on a side wave, and that's the way it feels in the water, to be honest. It's a fairly big volume hull. You do feel like you're up and you're buoyant when you're paddling it. But one nice thing I've noticed in my paddles, especially when I've been out in some bigger stuff, the more the boat is engaged at these secondary points of the hull here, so the bits where they transition from flat to vertical, the more of those secondary parts that get engaged by moving water, the more solid the boat feels on the water. So it is truly one of those skis, the bigger and badder it gets, the better it seems to feel. There's no real V through the boat other than up here at the bow, which is obviously a great assistance in helping it to track. You'll notice it's, as is the modern trend, fairly heavily raked. So the vertical bow shape has, you know, become a very rare thing as skis have developed and people have realised how important it is to be able to turn them. The bailer obviously can be closed flush, as you can see there. And down at this end, there's kind of a little trick to what makes it work, in my opinion. That's a fairly full stern. It's not a tapered, skinny, narrow stern. It is fairly deep in the water, even though there's a lot of stern rocker. So you can see that if you line that up alongside other skis, there's a fair bit there compared to most. And that's something that I think they've borrowed a little from their fairly advanced boat, the Ion. If I was to define the way this boat felt, people have said to me, is it like a faster Zen? No. Is it a more stable Evo? No. I would say it's actually a more stable Ion. It has that feeling of being up, out of the water, nice and buoyant. You know, you got to remember when things get bad, buoyancy is your friend. You want to be up and out of the water. And that's more or less how it paddles. Think you've got a lovely choice of rudders. This one is the 7-inch. There's a 9-inch, which is longer again, and that'd be worth a go if you wanted a bit more tracking. And then there's a couple of racing rudders and smaller ones too. Okay, so who's going to buy the ski? Who should be looking at it? Bearing in mind that it's not, as I've said, a stable Zen. If you've been paddling Think skis all the way through, you'll love the way that it feels exactly the same in the seat as all Think skis do. If you've been coming up from the Ease or the Ace to the Zen and are looking for something that goes a bit quicker, has a few more guns, then it's a very natural progression and well worth a look at your next boat. Of course, like a couple of other really good designs recently released, the guys and girls coming back from boats that are giving them a hard time will love this boat. I have paddled it now in a couple of big, nasty, southerly seas off Sydney where I thought I was going to get bashed around and be a bit slow to catch the runs, and I wasn't. I've had it out on bay downwinders in 40 knots and torn the ass out of it. Had a great time. Surfing waves on some of our favourite bar breaks, it carves around, manoeuvres around really nicely. And then in the hands of other paddlers, especially a few that I know who I figured might have been a little bit wobbly in it, the feedback I've come back with mostly has been, wow, that's really solid, stable. Some of the people who've been paddling very stable entry-level skis have found it a little bit less stable, but that next level up, the jump to here, if you want to compare it to an Evo, that's a ski I love. Man, the Evo, it's such a beautiful boat to paddle. This is a more solid feeling boat on the water than the Evo. It doesn't have quite the same amount of nuance and shifting around, but it doesn't heel this far before the secondary engages. It heels that far. And that, to a lot of people, is a very important distinction. So the bridge now between Fink's transition ski, the Zen, and their intermediate boats, well, the Evo kind of gets pushed up another category, if you ask me, by this one. This is a genuine intermediate ski, very much along the lines of the sorts of boats that I started paddling skis in, that weren't beginner boats back then, because there weren't any beginner boats back then. So coming back the other way, you're going to love this boat. I'm so enthusiastic that skis like this are becoming available, because at 6 meters, it goes fast. My two regular paddling buddies have both commented to me how fast I took off and shot away on waves that they were pumping hard on intermediate boats to try and catch me. As I said, I got no idea how fast I was going. I don't even bother checking the trace, to be honest. But you know when boats feel fast, when they feel like they're accelerating, and this is one of them. You'd expect that. 6 meters long, 48 centimeters wide. You'd expect it to have some get up and go. As far as the way Fink boats are built, their performance layups are bomb-proof. Man, some of the demos we've had over the years and the things we've done to them, they really are incredibly solid boats. They're about 14 and a half, 15 kilos nowadays. This one here is the Elite layup. It's about 11.9, 11.8 weighed. We only had it for a couple of months, but it's had a bit of a life, bashed around. I mean, I've only got to get in one for more than an hour, and I tend to run into things. And again, you know, really nicely finished. Thinks are every bit as well made as some of the boats you pay an awful lot more money for, or the boats that talk the game big when it comes to how nice their boats are. Think don't do that. They don't blow their horns at all, but they do make beautiful skis. You'll notice along here they've gone back to having a seam on their boats. I only got half the story as to why, but I believe it's about increasing the strength to weight ratio of the skis. Again, I don't really care about that. I just worry about what it feels like when I pick it up and how tough it is and how it's going to cope with all the knocks and the bangs that it gets. So our demo's here. If you're in another part of the world and you've got a Fink stockist who's got a demo on hand, get down, knock on their door, take it out for a paddle. I'm sure you're going to find it's a candidate for your next boat, whether you're coming up or down from an Elite boat. We're stoked to have it. We only really sell boats we like. If we don't like them, we'll get a demo in, have it for a few months, and then we punt them because, you know, life's too short, you know. I want to paddle them too. But this is definitely one I've been thoroughly enjoying paddling. If you'd like to give it a crack, give us a shout, get in touch. Or if you have any questions about this particular ski, let me know. I made that same comment on another review I did a couple of months ago, and I must have become the world's most asked person about it, according to my intro and my messages. So. But I mean, I don't mind. It's always good fun talking to paddlers. Thank you for watching. Remember, we're Expedition Kayaks, expeditionkayaks.com. We have a range of all the good brands of skis, all this cool gear, Vicobi, and all the stuff that makes the world go round. And we'd love to hear from you. See you later.
Took a whole jog 55.